Welcome to my Grey Hack Guide. In this episode, we're going to set up a shop. The last video I made setting up a shop is quite old, so I decided to make a new video in the current version of the game, showing how it's done. What we're going to do is we're going to use the hack shop HTML as a template. Now what I've done is I've already started trying to record this, and first of all I can show you. So let's nmap the hack shop. As you can see, it's a HTTP service. Now this is the version, and what happened when I tried to attack that with my script was that none of the exploits worked, so I had to use social engineering to get the admin online. The way I did it was I found the username for one of the users in the exploit log or whatever. When you try exploits and it says that it failed, I found one of the usernames, and I used that username in conjunction with the information from Whois to send this admin online template email. And so he responded, "Thanks for the reply," and reconnected to the network. The issue is that even with the root user online, I still can't get root access with my shell web script. And that means that it's going to take a little bit longer. And this admin is very aggressive. So he starts, at least he has started tracing me as soon as I enter the computer. Therefore, I'm going to be a bit more careful when I hack in here now and use a proxy chain. Yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to use shell web again. And let's just think this through. So I will need to... I will need to grab a exploit. When I did the hack, I also saw that there was a router, root password exploit, so we could inject another root password, and that way we will be able to get the root password, even though we can't read the password file. and put that on our. Maybe I don't have any more, so let's open another file explorer. We'll put that into downloads, perhaps. So that should be working, but it's not. Okay, there it goes. Now we have the HTML. And as you can see, this hack was a bit more complicated than usual. And usually you don't need to, well, sometimes you need to put the admins online, but if you do, you usually have access to the root password. In this case, we didn't. And on top of that, the admin is instantly tracing us every time we enter the server, so a bit extra work. That's why I had to set up before starting the recording. Okay, so we transferred the website, which is what we came for. And we also deleted the logs. Let's double check. Yep, looks clean. That's great. So now we can exit the server. And that should also cancel the trace, which it did. Let's open another admin monitor. I like to see if someone starts tracing us, easier if it's clean. We also got the server, which is the server right here. So what we can do is we can start another terminal. Starting to have a lot of stuff here. And in here, we're going to do SSH. I don't even remember how you use this, so you use SSH root path password and then the IP and then optional port. Since the standard SSH port is 22, we don't need to change anything here. And we're inside the server that we just rented. Then we'll open a file explorer. Well, we're going to need a few more things. Let's start with a browser. Then we're going to go back into the shop again from inside of this server. Pick one of the shops. And here we need the HTTP server. That will give us the web page. On the server. There we go. Then we're going to run that HTTP server. You need to run this as root. And you can see that it was successful. And it requires a port forward. We can do the port forward after we're done here. So we opened the file explorer. And what we're going to do is we're going to open another file explorer. Then we're just going to drag and drop the website. Maybe I should show this. So you take the web browser like this and you do ifconfig. You see that this is my LAN IP on here. Then if I paste that in here, you can see that it says we will be back soon. That's the default HTML page. If we were to go into public htdocs, we see that we have a website.html on our server already. This server, htdoc website.html is this right here. You can see here, we will be back soon in big letters, and then sorry for the inconvenience, blah blah blah, and down here. And this is what we will replace with this HTML right here. As you can see, it has buttons and it has some other text. Welcome to my personal store. Buy what you want. I will not ask questions. And the simplest way to do this is just to drag it over and replace. like that. Close and close these as well. And now if we update this, you can see that it's now the Hackshop page instead. And what this allows us to do is use the tools button. Exploit button won't work, and the jobs button will have no jobs except for create mission. But the tools one is what we can manipulate or fill with whatever we like. So inside of public htdocs, there is a downloads folder. And if we put stuff in here, for example, the website.html, and we update the page again, you can see now that in tools, there is a website.html that people can download. I'm not going to download it, but you can see that it works. So this is essentially how you set up a shop. You don't need to, but an easy way is to grab the HTML from either a hack shop. You can also grab the HTML from a shop, since that will give you access to this button right here, the shop button. So you just copy this page, and all of these files in here will also be in public htdocs downloads. Just put the stuff in there, and then the shop HTML template will work just as well as the Hackshop one. I think the Hackshop looks nicer, so we went with that one. And you just fill in whatever you want to sell, and people will be able to download it. Now, we're not completely done, because we need to be able to access this site from outside the network. So the this IP is a local IP, a LAN IP. So if I were to access that from a browser on, for example, my home system, as you can see, there's no orange bar here, so this is my home system, and I use that, you can see, please check the address and try again, you can't find it. And we want to be able to use the where did I put that? Maybe I closed it. Okay, let's open another one. Mail. So this rented server, we want to be able to put this public IP in the browser, and that should show us the hack shop. Now you can see it says you can't find port 80, and that is because even though we opened port 80 on the computer, we have not port forwarded it yet. And in order to do that, we need to go to 192.168.0.1, and this is the router configuration menu or page. In certain circumstances, it can also be 1.1 for some NPC systems, but for all the rented servers at the moment, it's 0.1, like so. There's already a port 22 port forwarded. That was the port that we entered the server with, so it's an SSH, and by default, like I told you, it uses port 22. But we will add port 80, both as the external port and the internal port. And then we're going to select the local IP, which was the IP we used to access the site from within the network. And that is going to make a tunnel or whatever, so that the a local IP can be accessed from outside of the network as well, and that's going to be accessed via the port 80. Let's save that, and now if we try to run this, we can see that we can actually access our hack shop from our home browser that is outside of the network. And you can see here's the website of the HTML that we put in the tools, and you can also download that down to our home computer. I'm just going to replace the website of the HTML like so, downloaded. So that's how you do that. Now, if you're playing in multiplayer, which I am at the moment, other players are going to be able to find this server, and as if they're decent, they will be able to destroy it. Therefore, we need to do a little bit of protecting, and the way we do that is by removing, well, you will use 422 to get onto the server. If you remove that, then you will not be able to enter the server with the SSH command. But it's also going to be more secure, so depending on how easy you want the server to be to access, you have to decide if you want to keep it or remove it. To make it more secure, removing it is of course best option, so that's what we're going to do. Remove 422. Now, even if we remove 422 like this, it's still going to be the port is still going to be running from inside the network. I can show that with my custom nmap tool, for example. So, as you can see here, port 22 SSH is still open and running, but it's not routed anymore. So I just removed the port forward or the routing. But in order to make the server more secure, we need to close the SSH service. And the way we do that is by going into CD server. In here, you can see that there is a few files, and the service files that are running on the server are located in this folder. So what we will do is we will do SSHD stop, and now it says the service SSHD has stopped successfully. So we both removed it and stopped it, which is going to be more secure. And if we now do the nmap, you can see that the SSH is not present anymore on the computer. The service is gone. So that's one of the steps to secure the server. Another step is to chmod the server. So if we do lsla, well, let's just do that, then we can see that the permissions on the different folders are, well, they vary. And R means that people will be able to read stuff that is inside and see stuff inside the folder. W means that they will be able to write stuff inside the folder, and X means that they can execute stuff. The first three letters are the user, well, the owner, and that is the first on the left side right here. So root, for root as the owner, has read, write, and execute permissions. Then the second three letters are the group, and for the server, the group is also root. So there's both a root user and a root group. Then the last three are others, which means those who are not the root users and who are not in the group. So since everything is root here, only users who are not root, which means others, well, that's going to be the threat. Others is usually what kind of permissions an attacker is going to have on the server. So these are the main concern, but in order to make it extra secure, I still recommend that we do chmod others minus read write execute. I don't remember. Let's see here. Chmod. So let's do R first. That means recursive, and that's going to go through everything, and not just one layer, but as many layers as there are folders deep into the system. So, okay, let's just show that as well. So we're in server now, right? You can see here, you can see that these files also have different permissions. And if we want, if we just do chmod without recursive, then it's just going to change the files inside one folder. But if you use the recursive option, then it's going to use the chmod on all the folders. And all the files inside the folders, and all the folders inside the folders, and so on. So let's do that. Let's do chmod recursive others minus rewrite execute, and the file we want to target is the main path, which is the path that contains all other paths, and therefore everything is going to be chmodded on the server. So that was others. Then we do group, and then we do users. Now if we do lsla, you can see that all permissions have been removed. So the only thing that will be able to do anything on here now is the root user. Same thing in server, same thing in user dash bin. You see, like so. To make it extra secure, you can remove everything you don't need. Yeah, there are even more tricks that can be used to make it extra secure. The more you know about the different tricks to hack into player servers, the better you're going to be able to protect the servers from such attacks. But these basics, just chmodding the server and removing the SSH and HTTP, the SSH port forward and the SSH service, is going to go a long way. As a final step, you can try to find a good library with few or none or no working exploits. So if we were to try to hack ourselves with the shell web script, let's do that as closing here. So, the shell web on port 80. Okay, so that's great. There are no shell access on the computer. So, shell web did not work. That's already kind of good. We, for example, had gotten a shell on here, we could have decided to try to find a better HTTP library and put that in the lib folder, right here, this folder. I think that's it. As you can see, even from outside the network, we can now access the shop that we made. And it's also fairly secure, so it's not impossible to hack, but I think that the player who hacks it has to be at least a little bit experienced. So this is how you do it. This is how you set up a server and how you steal a HTML and put that on the server, and then how you put files inside the download so that other people can buy them. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.